I've never been along here before. I don't know Kirkham all that well. This is basically sneaking into the back end of town, sneaking out of the back end of town, rather than going up a steep hill on the main road and then down another hill. And it's worked nicely. I don't know if this was here last time I came into Kirkham from this end, which was a number of years ago. So, I found myself in Kirkham for unrelated reasons, and I thought I would take an hour out to have a little bit of an exploration around this area. I've not really brought you here. One little bit of it you will have seen in summer going the opposite direction when I rode to Preston and Bob Jackson. And one tiny little bit of it, one bridge in fact, you've seen elsewhere. You'll recognise probably. I'm on the older Superbe. I'm trying out the 4-speed. This is the first time that these wheels and this hub and shifter have been out on this bike. They used to live on the hopper. Holding, it's nice to have that extra low gear. Crisp change to second, crisp change to third. Notoriously bad. The reason for that being is that they haven't made them for getting on towards 50 years. No, over 50 years. So they're all worn out basically. We're entering the village of Trails now. Not Trails, Trails. A lovely little village of cottages 10 years ago, but now it's becoming just a suburb, a housing estate. Too much of that garbage around as well. Whatever that purports to be. Let's hear it for the holdout though. The holdout king is this person here. Thank you. right opposite, of course. More new horrors going up. Something I've noticed, that people who buy up older properties and do them up, they try to make them look like new designer homes, all straight lines and horizontal and white square boxes. And yet, the people who actually buy new houses, they all seem to look like something from the 1990s. All these new estates that are going up, they've not really changed in 30 years what they're building. Good crap. They've got the same styling cues, the same jumble of styling cues of different periods of vernaculars as they had back in the 1990s, back in the last millennium. We've just passed where I had my puncture on the way to Preston on the Bob Jackson. Right, we're going up here on that Blackpool to Preston ride. And it was part two, wasn't it? I had the puncture. I also came down here as they were doing some repair works. These repair works, no doubt. Connected to the puncture. Lovely little lane, this one. Through those trees, but we can't see it, is Trent's windmill, now a house. And because we took that shortcut in Kirkham, we missed Kirkham windmill, which is now a house. But we will see that on the way back in, if I've got battery left by then. Held together by little spring washers holding things onto spindles, and one was just loose. Morning. Don't speak then, you wankers. Studiously looking the other way because I haven't got drop handlebars and a helmet. Pathetic. Suddenly pretend to see something in the other direction. That is definitely wanker behaviour. I just had a pause to take a couple of pictures and the jacket's off. We're down to a thin jumper and a t-shirt and a merino base layer. The Caradise camper long flap. Still doing sterling service, about 15 years old, I think. 17 actually now. Similar age to the saddle. Oh, you can stop it. Just fixed you. Magic sign for a chap such as myself, unsuitable for HGVs. Almost as good as unsuitable for motor vehicles. Which is almost as good as my favourite sign in these parts, which is no entry except cycles. That's the best one. Right now I'll take this. At least we've got some smooth tarmac. Relatively. And this is the first of our crossings today of the Lancashire Canal. Nice old farmhouse last time I was along here. Still I don't envy them. There's that thing at the bottom of the garden. Not this thing, I like this thing. That thing there, the motorway. but the kind of people who do that to old farm cottages are the kind of people who like living next to a motorway. So they're welcome to it. I wonder when the planning permission goes in for that. Sadly, no Roots Cafe today. I missed it. It's closed. But fair enough. Can't stay open all afternoon just for me. To eat, and then I'm going to ride back on the bigger roads just to get back really. Otherwise I would have gone onto the canal down here and ridden back along the canal towpaths. But is there any point in doing that if you're not here to come along for the ride? Of course, that is letting the video rule the ride, which I shouldn't do. Left. I might give you a few highlights of the ride home, but until then, that's where I'll be sitting. healthy wrap and my flask of tea within sight of the Superbe. Thanks for coming along. Try and get out if you can on your bike and stay safe, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye now. Well, the battery did run out completely, so I didn't get to give you any edited highlights of the trip home. It's later now, as you can see, I'm on a different bike, I'm on the Courier. Just done a quick Aldi trip, mostly for animal stuff. And on my way home, through the woods, so of course you can see bugger all. The blackbird giving it large there in the tree. Marvellous. I can see much more than you can see. The phone isn't very good at picking up the beam of the headlight. Anyway, as I was saying, not being able to film on the way back from the ride today means that's another ride. Next time I go out there, there's still lots of things to show you, and I will do a canal towpath ride in that area as well. So, going into the very dark part of the ride now. Here we are. The lane. This is the lane that I often go freewheeling down at the beginning of a ride when I've just got on the bike. Civilization. So now I really will sign off and say goodnight.